Adobe Photoshop is a registered trademark of Adobe Systems Incorporated, and I am in no way affiliated with Adobe.
Okay, so on this little clip here, I'm going to show you guys how to use masking to get your background separated from your dog. Or, in other words, I want to make the background completely white. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go down here and click on my bottom layer. And I'm going to click on that little button right there, which is create a new layer. Click on it, and I just created a layer between my very bottom one, which is just a reference layer, and my background layer, which is the one I'm working with. So what I want to do is fill it with white. You come down over here to your color swatches where you see my cursor, and you just hit the letter X, and it should switch to white. And if, say, for instance, two colors are, say there's black and red and there's no white to switch, you can hit the D command, D on your keyboard, and white and black will automatically be the preset. So now you want to hit X. Now to fill this background layer with white, what you're going to do is hit Alt, Alt Delete, and it filled it with white, as you can see. So now we have true right in the background. Now this is just one method of separating your dog, or actually putting your dog on a full white background. And this is actually one of the longer methods, and it's not the best method, but it can be pretty good. So you just click background, and now you want to go right there where it says add a vector mask. Click. Now we added a mask. You want to go to your paintbrush tool now, and now you have to paint with black to bring in what's down here. So whatever we're painting is bringing in what's on this bottom layer. So this is the way masking works. Whatever is beneath the mask is what is going to be showing up once you're painting. And I can show you right here as I paint over this line, it's going to disappear. Now your paintbrush might be on full hardness, and if it is, you're going to want to bring it down to like 12 or 11%. And the opacity, you can keep it at 100. So you just want to paint along with your mouse and get rid of all that. And get rid of all the stuff that doesn't look white, as you can see I'm doing. And if you accidentally paint over his foot, you can actually hit the X key to bring in white, as I just did right there, as you can see. White has been chosen now. If white is chosen, now you can paint back what you just did, as you can see I just did right there. So now you want to keep going with, hit X and keep going with your black. As you can see, I'm painting around everything that is not the dog. And this way I get an exact white background. Now say for instance, it's really hard to see what you have done. So if you hit the button that is right next to your right bracket key, it'll bring up all this pink. This is showing your mask. This is actually showing what you have done. So if I'm painting, it's going to paint in this reddish color because it's showing what I have done. Now look, I'm painting over the dog with red, but you can't tell anything has happened. If I unclick with the button that's next to my right bracket key, it's going to show that it took away from the dog. So if you hit your X button and bring in white, you can paint that all back in. Now, this is probably one of the longest methods of taking an item out of the background, or basically just adding a white background. But for some people, this is actually quicker. Some people actually like to do this. And the original image that I showed you earlier, this is actually what I did to paint the white back, to paint the white background. And in my opinion, this is probably one of the longer ways to do it. But back when I did this photograph, this is probably one of the only ways I'd like to separate stuff. As you can see, I'm separating all the stuff and making everything white. I'm even going to get rid of his tail here. As you can see, the dog is basically on a complete white background right now. And it looks good. Now, we could just reverse this dog, and we could basically get ourselves an image of the dog by itself. But I'm actually going to show you another way to do it on the next clip. So just listen up.